glutamic acid plays central role in the amino acid metabolism, and it is generated during the transamination reactions. Now, in transamination reactions, most amino acids transfer their amino group to the alpha ketoglutaric acid and form the glutamic acid. Glutamic acid is also formed during the metabolism of the histidine, proline, and arginine. Then, oxidative deamination. Glutamic acid is deaminated and form the alpha ketoglutarate plus ammonia by the enzyme glutamate dehydrogenase with the help of the NAD plus. Like this, glutamate deamination by the glutamate dehydrogenase that gives the alpha ketoglutarate. Then glutamine. Glutamic acid can react with a molecule of ammonia in the presence of the ATP, catalyzed by the glutamine synthetase to form the glutamine. And this reaction is important in ammonia trapping in brain as well as the transport of the ammonia in the body. Okay, like this, glutamine, proline, arginine, and histidine, they form the glutamate. Okay, from that glutamic acid is formed, and from the glutamic acid it's converted into the alpha ketoglutarate. Then glutamic acid enters into the TCA cycle, so it is a glucogenic, and it becomes the oxaloacetate and goes to glucogenic pathways. Then N-acetyl glutamate, NAG, NAG, it is a positive modifier of the carbamoyl phosphate synthetase 1, and this CPS1, it is important in for the urea cycle. Okay, then gamma carboxyglutamic acid, GCGA, it is present in the prothrombin. The gamma carboxy group is added as a post-translational modifications, and this needs the vitamin K. Then glutathione is a important constituent of the tripeptide. Okay, glutathione. Then GABA is a glutamic acid on decarboxylations gives rise to gamma aminobutyric acid. GABA is a inhibitory neurotransmitter because it opens the chloride channels in postsynaptic membranes in the CNS. Here, from the glutamic acid, it forms the GABA. Then, from the GABA, in the presence of the GABA oxidase, it forms the succinate semialdehyde. And from the succinate semialdehyde, it forms the succinate, which goes into the TCA cycle. Here, both the formation and catabolism of the GABA require the pyridoxal phosphate as a coenzyme. So, if pyridoxal phosphate deficiencies occur, it also affects the GABA synthesis, GABA performance. Okay, GABA shunt pathway is also affected. Here, the GABA is an inhibitory transmitter. A low level of the GABA would lead to the convulsions. And here, the sodium valproate, which inhibits the GABA oxidase, is used in the treatment of the epilepsy or seizures. Then excitatory neurotransmitter, and here the excitatory neurotransmitter, the neurons contains the NMDA and N-methyl D-aspartate receptors. Stimulation of the NMDA receptors by glutamate opens the calcium channels, and this leads to the stimulation of the nitric oxide synthase, and this results in the transient production of the nitric oxide. Nitric oxide binds with the high affinity to the guanyl cyclase, and the active guanyl cyclase raises the cellular level of the cyclic GMP. Okay, and this causes the vasodilatations. So nitric oxide also acts as a vasodilators in our body. And here, by activating the cyclic GMP in neighboring neurons, these neurons are the excited. The glutamine. Glutamine is a glucogenic amino acid, and it is synthesized from the glutamic acid. The formation of the glutamine in the brain and intestine is of special significance because it helps to fix the ammonia into the non-toxic form. glutamine is hydrolyzed to glutamate and ammonia by enzyme glutaminase, and this ammonia reacts with the hydrogen ions to buffer acids excreted in the urine. Okay, like this, glutamine synthase from the glutamine from the glutamate. The major fat of the glutamine is to be hydrolyzed to glutamate and ammonia. Okay, then nitrogen atoms of the 3 and 9 of the purines are derived from the glutamine. Then glutamine is also the source of the third nitrogen of the pyrimidines. Then glutamine is also the source of the ammonia amino group of the guanine and the cytosine. Then glutamine donates the amino group of the amino sugars and amide group of the nicotinamides. Glutamine is also act as a conjugating agent. Then aspartic acid. Aspartic acid is a non-essential glucogenic amino acid. Aspartate on transamination gives rise to oxaloacetate, and which initiate the TCA cycle. Then aspartate amino transfer the amino group of aspartate to the alpha ketoglutarate and form the oxaloacetate. Okay, oxaloacetate and glutamate is formed. Then AST aspartate amino transferase is increased in cardiac ischemia and in hepatic disease. Aspartic acid is an important member of the urea cycle, and it directly contributes to the alpha amino group of the urea molecules. The carbon skeleton of the aspartate can also enter the glucogenic pathway as a fumarate. Okay, citrulline plus aspartate, and they form the arginine plus fumarate. Aspartate is used for the synthesis of the purines, like first nitrogen and sixth amino group. Then the whole molecule of the aspartate is incorporated into the pyrimidine ring. Then aspargine. Aspartate react with the ammonia to form the aspargine. This reaction is similar to the formation of the glutamine. Aspargine can be hydrolyzed to aspartate and ammonia by the asparginase. L-asparginase is an anti-cancer drug against the leukemia and the lymphomas. Aspargine is a glucogenic amino acid. Aspargine loses the amino group from the R group by hydrolysis catalyzed by the asparginase, and this yields a aspartate which can be converted to the oxaloacetate by transamination reactions. Then lysine. Lysine is an essential amino acid, and it is deficient in the cereals. Lysine is predominantly ketogenic, and it does not undergo the transamination reactions. So here the bacterial putrefactions of the lysine give rise to cadaverin after the decarboxylations. Here the lysine and hydroxylysine residues of the collagen and elastins are important in the cross-linking. The epsilon amino group of the lysine can form the skiff linkage, attaching the coenzymes to the proteins. Okay. Then lysine is the precursor of the kinetin. Then arginine. Arginine contains the guanidinium group. It is highly basic, semi-essential amino acid, and it is glucogenic. In the urea cycle, the arginase splits the arginine into the ornithine and urea. Arginine react with the glycine to form the guanidoacetic acid, which is methylated to creatine. Arginine is the precursor of the nitric oxide, which is important signal molecule in the body. Nitric oxide, it is free radical, highly reactive free radical, uncharged molecule having the unpaired electrons. It is synthesized from the arginine by nitric oxide synthase, which contains the heme, FAD, FMN and tetrahydrobiopterin. Now, how its mechanism of action of the nitric oxide? The nitric oxide diffuses to the adjacent smooth muscles and activates the guanylate cyclase. Now, the increased level of the cyclic GMP activates the protein kinase G in the smooth muscles. Now the dephosphorylation of the myosin light chain occurs, so it leads to the relaxation of the smooth muscles, and thus the nitric oxide is act as a vasodilator. Now the physiological effect of the nitric oxide in the blood vessels. Nitric oxide is a potent vasodilator. Okay, it causes the cerebral, coronary, renal and muscle arteries to dilate. So a deficiency of the nitric oxide is associated with the hypertension. Excessive production of the nitric oxide results in the refractory hypotension, which may be seen in patients with septicemic shock. Then in central nervous system, it causes the release of the CRH, GHRH, LHRH. Okay, here in CNS, the glutamate act on the N-methyl D-aspartate NMDA receptor to cause a long-standing calcium influx, and this calcium influx activate the nitric oxide synthase to synthesize the nitric oxide. Okay, we stimulate the release of the releasing hormones. Then macrophages. Macrophages contains the isoforms, okay, of the nitric oxide synthase, which will produce the nitric oxide and peroxynitrite, which are lethal to the microorganisms. Nitric oxide production in macrophages is induced by the interleukins and tumor necrosis factors. Nitric oxide mostly used in some diseases and used as a treatment, like in angina pectoris. Nitroprusside can directly release the nitric oxides. Nitroglycerin requires glutathione to produce the nitric oxide. So these drugs will dilate the coronary arteries, and they are beneficial in treating the angina pectoris. Then in pulmonary hypertension, inhalation of the nitric oxide is useful. Okay, nitric oxide produces the pulmonary vasodilatation without lowering the systemic blood pressure. Then in cases of the impotency, nitric oxide relaxes the smooth muscles in the corpus cavernosum in the penis and increase the blood flow into the penis and makes it erect. So some patient take the Viagra. Viagra means sildenafil citrate, which causes selectively inhibit the specific phosphodiesterase type 5 and inhibit the hydrolysis of the cyclic GMP. So it increases the concentration of the cyclic GMP in the corpus cavernosum and causes the more increase of the penis, increases the blood flow into the penis and make it erect. Then polyamines. Polyamines are the putrescence, spermidines and spermin, and they are aliphatic amines. They are synthesized from the ornithine, and here the key enzyme of the polyamine synthesis is the ornithine decarboxylase, ODC, and it's required the pyridoxal phosphate. They are involved mostly in the cell proliferation, stabilization of the ribosomes and the DNA, synthesis of the DNA and the RNA, protection of the DNA against the depurinations, etc. So polyamine concentrations is increased in the cancer tissue. They are the growth factor for the cell culture systems. And polyamines, they are the markers for the cell proliferations. Here how the polyamines synthesize from the ornithine. Okay, in the presence of the ornithine decarboxylase, it forms the putrescence, then decarboxylations, and in the presence of the spermidine synthase, it forms the spermidine. Then from the spermidine, by the enzyme spermin synthase, it forms the spermin from the spermidine. Now branch chain amino acid, valine, leucine and isoleucine. Valine is a glucogenic amino acid, leucine is ketogenic, and isoleucine is both ketogenic and glucogenic amino acid, and these all three are the essential amino acid. They serve an important role as an alternate source of the fuel for the brain, especially in the conditions of the starvation. Now from the valine, isoleucine and the leucine, first reaction is the transamination and form the valine alpha keto isovalerate from the valine. Then from the isoleucine, it form the alpha keto beta methyl valerate, and from the leucine, it form the alpha keto isocaproate. Then the second step is the oxidative decarboxylation, and it formed the from the valine isobutyryl CoA. Then from the isoleucine it formed the 2-methylbutyryl CoA. Then from the leucine isovaleryl CoA. Now from the valine it formed the propionyl CoA, which goes into the glucogenic pathway. Then from the isoleucine it formed the acetyl CoA and propionyl CoA. Okay. Then from the leucine it formed the acetoacetate. Okay. And acetyl CoA. When the defect occur at the decarboxylation step, the second step, it causes the maple syrup urine disorder. Okay. Now let's see what is the maple syrup urine disease. It is called branch chain ketonuria. The name is so given because characteristic smell of the urine, it's like burnt sugar or maple sugar type smell due to the excretion of the branch chain keto acids in the urine. The defect, basic defect, is the deficient decarboxylation of the branch chain keto acids. Clinical findings are characterized by the convulsions, severe mental retardation, acidosis, coma, and death within the first year of the life. And its laboratory diagnosis, urine contains the branch chain keto acid and amino acids. Rothera's test is positive, but unlike in cases of the keto acidosis, even boiled and cooled urine will give this test. And treatment, giving a low diet containing the low branch chain amino acids, mild variants will respond to high doses of the thiamine, and this is because the decarboxylation of the branch chain keto acid required the thiamine. Liver transplantation has been successfully tried in some cases of the maple syrup urine disorder. Thank you.